Yo, what's up, Dynamite? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing tutorial. Guys, this one is going to blow you away. We are going to create that fake RGB lights in Photoshop. If you don't have gels in your studio, if you don't have this colored light in your studio, no problem. I got you covered. Add this spice to your portraits and you will be amazed. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to first come create a new layer by clicking down here, right there, and we're going to name this red because you're going to use the red color, red. And we're going to get our gradient tool. Where is the gradient tool? It's just right here below the paint bucket, just here. And then we come here into the color swatch and we select the color red. Let's get this red here, that one, a bright red. So what are we going to do now? You come here up here and you make sure one side, you select the second knob of the gradient, because one side has to have color and the other side has to be transparent, because we want the light actually coming in through one direction and splashing all the way this way, but in a gradual kind of way, right? Okay, we say okay. So we get our gradient tool and come here and then we just pull it all the way here. Let's do this again. I just have so that I have it thicker, just like that. So what are we going to do here? We're going to change the blending mode now to color. Very simple. We are getting there, right? So let us go duplicate this particular layer again, just like this. And this one we're going to rename it, we're going to rename this green. The colors, definitely, it's all up to you. And what we are going to do, we are just going to come and click, get the move tool here, click over here, and then we right click and say horizontal flip, so that we put it on this other side of the frame, just like that. We don't want it to be so closer, we want it to be a bit far, you know, like that. So what are we going to do? You just come select it, press Ctrl Alt U on your keyboard so that you get the gradient, and then you just play around with the gradient. This, of course, this is all your choice, just like that. And then boom, we are good. Now you see we are already there almost, but there is one single ingredient you would really love to add into this that is going to really amaze you. Let me show you how we're going to do this. Now we want the red color to be, we want the side of the light to have some kind of hot spots and some kind of shadows. So how do we create those hot spots? Those hot spots are going to create more of a three-dimensional kind of feel around the edge and give it more depth so that it doesn't look too fake. So how would we do that? So we come here and create a new layer like that, and you're going to name this red pop. Yeah, and then what we are going to do, you come actually here in the red pop right here, and then get this, the paint bucket tool, and then pour in paint. So we are going to pour in red paint, and then we change this to what they call color dodge. Where is it? Right there. See, now what are we going to do? We're going to create a layer mask just right next to this one, just like that. A layer mask, and then press Ctrl I on your keyboard just to invert, Ctrl I, like that. And then we are going to come and get our brush tool, and then we reduce the opacity and flow to 16, and let us put the flow to around, I think 20 is enough, and we're going to now begin building that three-dimensional kind of feel. So how do we do that? You come here, select, make sure it's the layer mask that is selected, the black one, and then we are going to come over the edge and paint white over here, just around the edge like that. You just come building it over the edge. So we just also come here, you build it slowly. Remember, we are only doing this to create depth within the whole image. Usually there is I'm using a soft brush to do this so that we have this. Really, you don't have to be a painter really to do this. You just paint over the edge, like around that area. I'm just assuming where the light would have been hitting, really, like that. So I'll just come also here, around here. Maybe if the light is hitting from that direction, it would most probably come hit here and it moves over the nose area, just like that. Maybe put some bit of red light around there. Really, it doesn't have to be perfect, because we're just giving an illusion around here, maybe, since this one also protrudes out a bit, maybe around there, maybe around here too, so that we give that part of the head more shape. Maybe we could also shine it around that area. Basically, it's your imagination that So the same thing is what we are going to do for the green channel. So how we do that, let me just come and put it back to normal before I put it in color so that I get a color sample. So I'll just come here, get my paint bucket, then press Alt on the control on the keyboard, just like that. I'll put this back to its blending mode, which is color, the original blend mode, which was color. So I'll just create another layer just right on top here by clicking over here, and then I'll name this green pop. Yep. And then I'll just come and pour the paint there, and then I'll just come and put this into what they call a color doge. Where is our color doge? I'm just too excited, that's why I'm not even seeing the knob. So the next thing you're going to do, you're just going to create just a layer mask just right next to it. As always, press Ctrl I on your keyboard to invert the layer mask so that it's off, and then we get our brush tool, still using the same opacity and flow. We're just going to come over the edges here, and then we paint over the edge. Where we paint over the edge is we want to give it more of a three-dimensional kind of feel, more depth to the whole image, so that it doesn't look flat. Just like that. So we paint over the edge, you know, just to give that illusion of a backlight of a rim light. Yeah, still we can just come here and maybe create another highlight around there. So basically you just come paint building it slowly until you have something that really amazes you. It is that super simple. I mean, guys, let us just put this in a group. I'll put these, the pops, in their own group by selecting them and dragging them into the group, and I'll call these pops. Then I'll put the RGB lights, these ones, into their own group, just like that. And I'll call these RGB lights. So what if I want them to be a bit thicker than they are? I just come here and duplicate this, just like that. So if when you look at that and that, so we've made it even pop. So here what you have to do is just come maybe and at the top here, get your curves adjustment layer and just do a general color correction over the whole thing, just like that, so that you give it that kind of. And I mean, that's that. I feel for my test it is too popping, so I'll just come and reduce it just a little bit here, the opacity of one of the thing, and then come here also pump down a little bit of the curves adjustment layer, just reducing its flow. And yeah, guys, that's that for today. I hope you enjoyed this simple tutorial. I'll see you in my next tutorial, and remember to subscribe if you want to blow up into creativity. I want to see you grow, and I'll see you next time, and adios.